suffering.
No, this is absolutely beautiful. I've never seen the trees like this. Really, this is, that's beautiful.
Good year for things like that. Well, that's cool. Let's sit down. Come in. Take the
big chair.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Good to be back, particularly in this weather. Get a look at my garden back in D.C. here.
This, I can't get you. This is the biggest surprise, the wall of a sudden 90 degrees.
I have a tenant who doesn't realize what it is to have a garden and that you have to water occasionally. The other thing, no water, no rain this whole month.
Oh.
So, anyway, we had snow as I left Moscow, still on the ground. But other than that, the climate with Tip O'Neill's visit was warmed up slightly, at least I got to see the new leader. And it was quite an experience. It was 4 hours, almost 3 hours and 45 minutes. And I recommend that, as soon as this is private, these are internal people here. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay, that's all right. That, if there's going to be a meeting at some time, you just read that conversation because it tells you a lot about how he handles himself, sort of techniques he uses to talk. And he's a very smooth, rather convincing kind of talker. In other words, there's no bombast. It's very calm. He asks a series of rhetorical questions to kind of keep his thought running. Also keep the floor, and I think particularly visitors on his territory have a tendency to be a little too polite not to interrupt and make comments on what he's saying. He does not use ideological language. I mean, he really gives a kind of open Western appearance, but when you analyze the arguments that he's used, he's a pretty narrow fellow. Very set views of how the world works. And according to their style of analysis, what is scientific analysis of world history?
Yes. President John Sloan.
John, yes, how are you?
Well, I'm excited about this big effort. We're going to get that $50 billion.
Hey,
I appreciate what you're doing.
Well, see.
Appreciate your understanding. We're right behind you on this effort to pair the old Social Security back a little bit. I think you'll find the small business are strong about what you're doing here. We also,
Mr. President,
Mike Kelly. Nice to see you again, sir.
Good to see you.
My pleasure.
Mike was one of the point people for Free Enterprises for Reagan Bush.
I know. I was just going to say thanks to you for that, not only for the support that you've given us before, but now on this new plan.
And this is David Cullen.
David Cullen.
Yes. Yes. Hi, how are you?
And I must say, we appreciate the understanding of keeping some of the city up in the Congress and small independent agencies. We fully support the idea that we've got all shared cutting expenses and cutting some of those SP programs like all those ongoing. We're 100% behind you.
I'm glad to hear that. You don't hear that too often.
So you got a great weekend for Camp David.
I say, I want you all to know that you're looking forward to it too.
I bet you are.
I'm taking a 7-year-old, 13-year-old horseback riding, so I know it's interesting because I hope you enjoy the same maybe this weekend.
Well, as a matter of fact, we've ordered the horses for tomorrow.
Oh, that's great.
We'll be able to ride up.
Super.
Well, listen, I think it's just great. You've been helpful to us all the way back to the very beginning, and now on this one, I think that this is really a kind of a watershed. This move, I think, puts us on the path to getting where we can look down the line and see where the budget will be balanced.
Right, sir.
Our people tell us that's where they want us to help you get that budget, so we'll be there working for you.
All right. Well, God bless you.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. This is Mary Wiley. Mary is my secretary.
Well, hello there. That's
my pleasure.
Well, it's nice to see you.
I'm trying to follow your example. Look harder and look younger.
Good enough.
And this is Todd Foley, my staff assistant.
Hello there. Well, nice to see you.
Great to see you.
And I'm going to grab one more if you don't
mind. I think they missed that.
Right.
Thank you.
See, I want to tell you about that working hard thing. Nancy had an experience in New York. She went up that physical fitness thing, you know, our federal program. George Allen, the coach on the commission. And in came about, she said, she didn't count them exactly, but she said it looked like about 20 gals, all in the leotards and everything, that were going to kind of perform for the group. She said, everybody was like that of a chorus girl. Mm-hmm. They were all between the ages of 65 and 85.
You're kidding.
She said one gal had just had a shape that you couldn't believe, 83 years old.
Oh.
And she just kept saying, I don't believe it, I don't believe it. I kept saying, it's true, it's true. And finally she asked them, she said, well, you know, when did you start? All of them had only started within the last 5 years. And then to kind of prove the point, you know what they did? They all went into a split.
Oh. I can't do that now.
I was going to say, I could have
too young.
But she said it was the most amazing thing she ever. So then they did a, you know, some maneuvers of that kind for the dinner.
Oh. Mm. Well, everyone we hear is jealous about Mrs. Reagan's figure because she's so slim. When the comments we hear when we bring people through the West Wing and they see the photographs, how does she stay so small?
The other night at the steak dinner, my daughter Maureen was there, and Nancy was something or other talking to them, and then Nancy turned to go to someone else, and she turned sideways. Kirby said to whoever she was talking to, she says, where'd she go? Well, I keep telling her to eat.
Well, she is slim. She looks great. But so do you. You look great. Well, thank you. Have a good weekend, too. Good riding tomorrow.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Joe.